Have a seat, please. I'm told you don't deny crimping Brady Hartsfield's oxygen line. Is that true?
Do I need a lawyer?
I don't know. Do you?
Look, I finished his line. I thought about choking him out. Then I thought better about it. Okay? Everything is subjective.
Well, that's not a very helpful response. And I hope it's not indicative of your attitude. Mr. Hartsfield has engaged Merrill D. Shields. I think that name probably rings a bell. Mr. Shields has a very successful record of putting law enforcement on trial.
Brady Hartsfield mowed down 16 people at a jobs fair with a Mercedes. He murdered his boss. He tried to blow up thousands at an arts gala. No disrespect to Merrill D., whoever the fuck. But I don't really fancy his chances here.
I want to nail Brady Hartsfield every bit as much as
the fuck. But I don't really fancy his chances here.
I want to nail Brady Hartsfield every bit as much as you do. But my concern right now is that you may be the weak link in the chain.
How so?
How so? Seriously?
That was my question. How so?
Well, let's see. You stalked and harassed Sadie McDonald, who ultimately jumped to her death, landing at your feet. You stalked and pursued Al Jurcik, who you ultimately shot and killed.
What is this? This is your life?
Last year, you withheld material information and evidence from the police regarding Brady Hartsfield. A decision which contributed to the death of one Janie Patterson.
Fuck you. Fuck you.
I heard you the first
time. No. Fuck you again.
According
according
to the records of your ex-partner, Peter Dixon, there was enough evidence to charge you with obstruction of justice. Now, I would endeavor to question Detective Dixon further, but as you know, he was found dead in your kitchen.
You smug prick. Are you fucking kidding me?
You don't think these are issues?
What the fuck is this?
You know, I can handle loose cannons like you, but what I can't handle is loose ends. They make me nervous. Let me ask you something. When you shot and killed Al Jurcik, were you under the impression that you were really shooting Brady Hartsfield?
I didn't say that.
No? Well, did you ever say that you believed Brady Hartsfield was inhabiting the mind and body of Al Jurcik?
Well, now you see, I'm concerned there that Merrill D. Shields might make hay on that one.
Okay, look,
I'm not on trial here.
Don't be too sure. According to Brady Hartsfield, you two engaged in continued communication right up until the attempted bombing at the Edwards Art Gala.
But I told Pete Dixon that.
Oh, really?
I kept him in the loop,
I saw no evidence of that as well.
Not at all. Enough of this bullshit.
Yeah? Did you have enough of Felix Babineau's bullshit last night when you assaulted him at the hospital?
What the hell is this?
You might be a material... Bullshit last night when you assaulted him at the hospital?
What the hell is this?
You might be a material witness in all of this. And the idea of my case turning on your credibility is rather disconcerting right now.
You know what? You can go and fuck yourself. Am I free to go?
Well, you got someplace you gotta be.
Are you detaining me, you piece of smug shit, or am I free to go?
Don't leave the jurisdiction.
Fuck you very much.
Oh, and one last thing.
The teenager that you pulled the gun on last year in your backyard, he was climbing over the fence. Just in case that should come up.
Were you inebriated at the time? The responding officer claims that you were.
I can't remember.
Were you inebriated?
I can't remember. Too drunk, allegedly.